It is vital to know the most important characteristics of global audiences. In this way, you will perform your craft or go into your subject having in mind the characteristics of the people you want to touch with your words. After all, to get it right and have a performance that will urge people to walk up to you and congratulate you after the end of your presentation, you need to understand and comprehend that it's not about you, it is about your audience. Your main and only concern should be to get your point across to your audience in a way that is concise, coherent, and above all, concrete. If they like you in the process, well, that's just an added bonus. So let's look at the seven characteristics of global audiences. Characteristic number one is that audiences are less patient. According to a recent statistic, the average adult attention span has fallen from 12 minutes to 5 minutes. And these are the good news. The not so good news is that the first 8 seconds will determine if your audience will stay with you for the rest of your talk. Hence the need to start strong when it comes to your presentation. Characteristic number two, there are lots of distractions. In the old days, that is the days before the mobile devices and especially the smart devices were invented, people used to walk into a conference room bare naked in terms of devices and distractions. Today, as I tour the world and address audiences of all sizes and nationalities, I see people walking into the training with their personal assistants, with their filing cabinets, and with their board games. That's when they get bored, they play games on their smart device. So keeping the attention of your audience for the whole duration of your talk should be your number one goal. Characteristic number three is lack of time. Odds are that the people you will be addressing are not so much money poor as they are time poor. To be an interesting and captivating speaker, you need to respect people's time. As the former Prime Minister of the United Kingdom, Winston Churchill, once said, a speech should be like a miniskirt. It should be short enough in order to be attractive and long enough in order to cover the essential parts. Characteristic number four, there is an information overload. According to a Google statistic, 5 exabytes of information and data are exchanged every 2 days on the World Wide Web, which correspond to the exact same information and data that were exchanged from the dawn of civilization until 2003. People are bombarded with information and data, so you need to search for the latest and greatest statistics and stories so that you will not only illustrate your point, but you will also illuminate the room with your facts and your figures. Characteristic number five, the way we receive information has changed. We are addressing a very visual nation. People are not so much convinced by words as they are convinced by images imprinted by the presenter in their hearts and in their minds. Hence the need, as we will see later on in this online course, to create a multi-sensory experience that will stay with people long after they are gone from your talk. Characteristic number six, we're addressing a very knowledgeable audience. We're addressing the most informed, the most demanding, and the most knowledgeable audience of all times. The rise of search engines, the likes of Google, and artificial intelligence have empowered global audiences to retrieve information very fast. So be prepared to make sure that you get your information in order so that you successfully drive your points home. We will see later on how we can back up each and every one of your statements so that they are understood and accepted by your audience. Characteristic number seven, your audience needs to feel special. Dale Carnegie said it first in his book, How to Win Friends and Influence People. He said, be interested, not interesting. The same applies to the speakers and presenters who want to win audiences and influence outcomes. People want to feel acknowledged and special. And you can only do that by showing them that you have researched them as your audience and you have understood their needs and concerns. That means, as we will see later on, knowing how to develop empathy and vulnerability as a speaker. So the million-dollar question is, how do you address a knowledgeable audience who wants to feel special but has little patience, little time, and a short attention span? The next video is an eye-opener, my friends, and perhaps the most influential step to starting on the right foot, or better say, starting with the right words.